Robotics has been around for 50 years, the evolution of the eye for about 500 million years. What do you think, who's winning?
Welcome to Talking Autonomy. In today's episode, we're joined by Volkmar Uhlig, the CTO and co-founder here at Ghost. We thought we'd start by getting into a little bit of the background of the technology behind Ghost, what inspired the neural networks and the science behind. And Volkmar, one of the early things you told me was all about biology and trying to understand some of the connections between human biology and computer vision. So why biology? Why is that the right place to start?
So robotics is now 50 years old. Biology is much older. You know, the eye, development of the eye really started splitting about 500 million years ago. Mm. And the human eye is very fascinating how many functions it has. And so when we looked at it for driving, the only thing we know which is able to drive a car is a human. And so it's a really good example of, you know, how you could build a system, because we have an existence proof that it actually works, which mm-hmm. is not given to us by robotics. And so we looked at the eye, how the human eye is working, and it has all these different functions, how we can see distances and how we can see motion. Mm. And we thought that, you know, if we have these functions which are already implemented and well tested many times a day on our roads, then why don't we go down that route?
But you said there were many functions, so walk us through that a little bit. How are all the different ways the eye works to perceive motion and depth?
So the human eye, we have seven different ways how we can actually see a distance. And from the most extreme is like really close up, where we measure the tension of the muscle tilting our eyes into focus. For us, more important is like the seeing further away. So the human eye can see about 6 meters out in stereoscopic, which is right at the edge of the hood, which is not really useful. Mm. But when you have cameras with really high resolution, you can see much, much farther.
Mm. So we can take that stereo effect within our cameras and stretch it out to what might be hundreds of meters.
Correct. So we are somewhere in the range between 75 meters to 150 meters, depending on the resolution of the camera and how far the cameras are apart. But then you have other mechanisms. So for example, we can see, we have parallax. And so when you're shifting your head, the objects which are further away move much less horizontally than an object which is close up. Mm. And so as the car is driving and is moving, we can actually figure out that parallax. Also, as we are getting closer, objects expand, and so we can see objects that are closer expanding more than objects that are further away. And so that is something which is directly observable with the normal camera. Hmm.
So you can basically take all these different effects between stereo, parallax, you know, expansion of objects, and then train them in a neural network that you pair with the camera?
That's correct. So like it's the neural network then just effectively gives us an estimation of how far things are away or how fast these things are moving towards us. And that's what we have in our brain, right? It's the neural network just gives you a direct answer in, you know, the order of milliseconds. Mm.
And then, of course, humans, we have two eyes, mostly pointing forward unless we rotate our head. We can do a little bit better than that with our car. So how do you think about that surround vision and the capabilities?
A human is really made for like a very universal application. And so your eyes are, you know, they are moving in your head. That's a really like mechanical motion. It's really bad if you want to do this in an industrial installation. So you want to glue it into a windshield and you want to have it really solidly installed. And so instead of having mobile eyes, we effectively just install many around them, because from our perspective, it's just, you know, a couple of dollar installation, and we can place them in all the right locations so that we get a 360 view. So we're humans, we have rear view mirrors, and, you know, we are using them as an alternative because we don't have eyes on our back. In a car, we can just install a camera in the back.
So there you have it. The world of biology basically is adapted to computer vision, where we take the same algorithms that are powering the eye for hundreds of millions of years, and then code them into neural networks, pair them with high fidelity sensors, and make them surround instead of just coming out of the front of the car. Fascinating stuff. In future episodes, we'll talk a lot more into the details of the algorithms themselves and how the neural networks that power Ghost work. But for now, thanks, Volkmar. We'll talk next time. Thank you.